a lot of success in restaurants is about the story. When people come into the restaurant, we say, our oysters come from 100 feet offshore. Well, they perk up, say, wow, well, and the guys who are raising those oysters grew up here. They've been here all their lives. So that's a story you can really get behind, and it makes it easier to get people excited about trying it. I mean, how can you get any closer than 100 feet offshore to the restaurant? Yeah, we grow great oysters down here. We have clean water. The St. Mary's River is in good shape. The Potomac gets cleaner every year. The bay is slowly, coming back. So we have, the watershed is healthy and getting healthier all the time.
I'm partial to the river oysters. They're plump, they're delicious, they're healthy. There's nothing but goodness that comes from them.
The farther up the river you go, you got more brackish water, and the farther you go towards Solomon's and all like that, you got more saltier water. And, the Patuxent has a unique flavor to itself because of that.
We could take an oyster from the lower river and an oyster from the upper river and do a side-by-side taste of the two. You would notice a difference. So to say Southern Maryland, you could have some oysters from Point Lookout, oysters from the Patuxent River, or oysters from the Potomac, with three entirely different tastes.
During the summer months, the wild harvest oyster, they're spawning, so their texture changes, their flavor changes, they get a milkiness to them. The farm-raised oysters stay consistent year-round because they are sterile, so instead of reproducing in the summertime, they're just getting fat and delicious, and the texture, the quality, everything stays consistent year-round.
The meat is very plump and juicy no matter what time of the year you eat a farm-raised oyster. So, but we do both, we supply both.
I happen to like the sexy oysters. Those are the ones that are raised in the wild and still have their reproductive organs. But I think it does add flavor to it.
The oyster quality is so excellent here. It's available year-round, contrary to what a lot of people think. You can do, especially with us, we're right from water to the walk-in. The dishes I'm making today, Rockefeller and Casino, are both delicious. One and a half shell with a little mignonette is excellent. So there's a lot of good ways to eat oysters. So the Casino is a combination of red and green bell peppers, a little shallot. It's heavy on garlic. It's a very garlicky dish. And it's topped with a little bacon and butter. Rockefeller, on the other hand, has spinach, and it's a little creamier. It's got more, we put Parmesan cheese and a little panko, and it gets roasted up a little bit, a little crispier, shallots. A couple different interpretations of baked or roasted oysters, and good segues into trying one on a half shell.
They're safe, they're healthy. There's nothing but goodness that comes from them.
Watermen are on the state seal for Maryland, so I think that shows just how important watermen are to the history of Maryland. In 2008, the state of Maryland started a Watermen's Heritage Tourism Training Program. It really worked for me because I'm a school teacher here in Calvert County, and I really get to blend what I do on the water with teaching people about it.
We're educating the public every time they come in. We're showing them the oysters and how it filters the water. We go to schools and we educate them also. But it's very, very important that we keep that heritage coming so that not only are we cleaning the water and doing beneficial things for the environment, but we're also promoting our heritage and trying to get younger people involved.
For me to start the heritage tours, it's about getting six people hands-on to show them that this is what our oysters are doing. I think we are hopefully definitely part of the future. There is not a waterman out there that doesn't want a healthy population of oysters. We're all stakeholders in this game.
Everybody before me has worked the water here. My grandmother, grandfather, father, everybody. So it's nice to keep a tradition alive.
What keeps me going is wondering what's gonna come up in the next pot or what we're gonna find the next day. So I get up each morning really excited to start the day, probably more excited than somebody should.
This is a business that my husband and I started, and we started out very, very small. We've gotten larger, and we just thoroughly enjoy what we do.
We just like the quality, the local nature, supporting our local businesses and enterprises, supporting the local watermen community. So everything about it works for us.
My favorite way to eat oysters is not only how they're served, but with who you eat them with. And I absolutely love our local bull and oyster roasts.
I personally like them in a casserole with melted cheese and bacon.
You know, I, anyway, oysters are just good.
I mostly eat them straight from the shell, just raw, you know. It's quick and easy.
I want them in my living room with the TV, the remote, and I don't want a bunch of people around because I want to eat them all.
So for me, it's not only about the flavor or the way that the oysters are prepared, but it's also about who you enjoy them with and how you enjoy them.
Oh, and they are delicious.